possible. That very possible be your result.
Grand meal, that was.
Yes.
Nothing like a good glass of Chateau Le Chasseler, eh,
Josiah? Hey, right there, Obadiah.
Right.
Who'd have thought 30 years ago we'd all be sitting here drinking Chateau de Chasselet, eh?
Aye. In them days, we was glad to have the price of a cup of tea.
Aye.
A cup of cold tea.
Aye.
Without milk or sugar.
Or tea.
Aye. In a cracked cup and all.
Oh, we never had a cup. We used to have to drink out of a roll-up newspaper.
The best we could manage was to suck on a piece of damp cloth.
But you know, we were happy in those days, though we were poor.
Because we were poor. My old dad used to say to me, money doesn't buy you happiness, son.
I was right.
I was.
I was happier then and I had nothing. We used to live in this tiny old house with great big holes in the roof.
House? We were lucky to live in a house. We used to live in one room, all 26 of us. No furniture. Half the floor was missing and we were all huddled together in one corner for fear of falling.
Yeah, you were lucky to have a room. We used to have to live in corridor.
Oh, we used to dream of living in a corridor. Would have been a palace to us. We used to live in an old water tank and a rubbish tip. We got woke up every morning by having a load of rotting fish dumped all over us. House.
Well, when I say house, it was only a hole in the ground covered by a sheet of tarpaulin. But it was a house to us.
We were evicted from our hole in the ground. We had to go and live in a lake.
You were lucky to have a lake. There were 150 of us living in shoebox in middle of the road.
Cardboard box?
No.
You were lucky. We lived for 3 months in a paper bag in a septic tank. We used to have to get up at 6 a.m, clean the paper bag, eat a crust of stale bread, go to work down mill, 14 hours a day, week in, week out, for 6 months a week. And when we got home, our dad would thrash us to sleep with his belt.
Luxury. We used to have to get out of the lake at 6 a.m, clean the lake, eat a handful of hot gravel, work 20-hour day at mill for 2 pence a month, come home and dad would thrash us to sleep with a broken bottle if we were lucky.
Well, of course, we had it tough. We used to have to get up out of shoebox at 12 o'clock at night and lick road clean with tongue. We had 2 bits of cold gravel, worked 24 hours a day at mill for 6 months every 4 years, and when we got home, our dad would slice it in two with bread knife.
Right. I had to get up in the morning at 10 o'clock at night, half an hour before I went to bed, drink a cup of sulfuric acid, work 29 hours a day down mill and pay mill owner for permission to come to work, and when we got home, our dad and our mother would kill us and dance about in our graves, singing hallelujah.
And you try and tell the young people of today that, and they won't believe you.
They won't.